over the world, oceans are in trouble.
Deforestation.
Amazon loss.
Mangrove loss.
Melting glaciers.
Fires are getting more intense.
Traditional West African pastoralist lifestyles are being affected.
There are communities who are struggling to survive.
There's so much going on in the world, but there are so many people wanting to make a difference, so many people enthusiastic about what they do.
We are using Google Earth to monitor the forest and the illegal activity in Indonesia.
To make remote sensing more equitable and inclusive for everyone.
To create virtual tours of sites related to slavery.
To bring attention to the health disparities that have affected these marginalized communities during the pandemic.
Provide training, tools, and technology that supports Indigenous self-determination and environmental stewardship.
To create immersive, interactive content to improve quality of education in public schools.
We are monitoring community wells for pH, turbidity, and coliform.
We are tracking human impact on global mangrove ecosystems.
To generate deforestation alerts monthly in the Brazilian Amazon region.
We're using Google Earth Engine to show people where and when to expect the biggest impacts from sea level rise.
To estimate the pollution levels in different parts of the country.
To take the world virtual diving.
The Earth Engine plays an important role to mitigate climate change. We can tell the changes chronologically. And by making a single picture, we are telling the public, here is the area that the problem might occur in the future.
Fires are having a massive impact on this area. The satellite imagery we source from Google Earth, Google Earth Engine, has really enabled people to extract information that they would never have accessible before. And that really helps us pinpoint where we need to look at on the ground.
We have now started partnering with Google to give every hut a unique address. We've been very steadily using Google Plus codes, which can be ingested on Google Maps so that anybody could navigate to that particular house.
We are using Google Earth to reclaim and rename our cultural sites to our traditional names.
Earth Engine is definitely one of the tools in NASA's toolbox. Running our processes in the cloud and not having to download things, Earth Engine has been a game changer.
I'm just so glad that this Geo for Good Summit is going to happen. It's good for people to be connecting even more now.
The community at Geo for Good are those people that care about the environment, they care about making a change for the world, and they're willing to help in every way that they can.
Just meeting other like-minded people and the actual expertise that they bring, they're actually willing to share and give more.
During the week, I meet so many great people from different fields.
Really fascinating to see in different countries how people are using Earth Engine.
And just knowing that the community is still there and knowing that there's other people out there that you can talk to, you can relate to, you can work with is absolutely amazing.
We are preservationists.
We are public health practitioners.
We are remote sensing scientists.
We are conservationists.
We are a group of volunteers.
We are researchers.
We are world changers.